Walker, and I will be your moderator for this class. Welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school and not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organizations. This school is a non-profit, non-denominational, religious, and scientific research organization dedicated to showing proof of the existence of Yahweh our Elohim and the operation of His eternal purpose, pattern, and plan operating throughout eternity to this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelation given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kendall, in the state of Ohio in the year 1931. We were incorporated in the state of California in the year 1958. We hold classes in the United States, Canada, and certain other foreign countries. The Chicago Northside Branch was established in the year 2007. The dean of the Chicago Northside Branch is Dr. John Quakes. The president is myself, Dr. Brandon Walker, and the vice president is Dr. Patrick Latortu. In this school, we use the true, correct, and original name and title of the Father, the Word or Son, and the Holy Spirit, which are contained in the original Hebrew text. The true name of our Heavenly Father is Yahweh. It has been improperly substituted by Lord. The true title for the Word or Son is Elohim. It has been improperly substituted by God. The true name of the Holy Spirit, whether manifest in or out of a physical body, is Yahshua. It has been erroneously substituted by Jesus Christ. Now, Lord and God are titles. They are not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8:5 that there are Lord's many and there are God's many. But we know that each Lord must have a name and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title, but unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. That means that Elohim is the title that our Creator chose for Himself. Jesus is a name, but it is an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part in a good dictionary or encyclopedia would prove that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin languages have any letters or characters in their alphabet that would produce the sound that is made by this letter J. Neither was there a letter J in the English language until some 1400 years after the Messiah's death, therefore making such names as Jesus and Jehovah impossible renderings of the true, correct, and original name and title of our Heavenly Father and His Son. Christ is a title just like Lord and God. Now, Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state, He is incomprehensible and inscrutable. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits, and bounds of everything. We have Yahweh and His pure spirit state symbolized on this chart as a cloud. Yahweh is not a cloud. He merely chose a cloud to symbolize Himself because a cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. We have drawn this cloud all around the edges of this chart to show you that everything within this chart is within the cloud. And in like manner, everything in the universe abides within the pure spirit state of Yahweh. Yahweh, knowing that man could not perceive of Him in his pure spirit state, took on shape and took on form right within Himself as Elohim. This is the Word or Son, a super incorporeal being that is having the shape and form of a man but without flesh and blood. This form can only be seen in divine visions and understood in divine revelations. Later on, this self-same spirit manifests Himself in a physical body and walk the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah, whom the world calls Jesus Christ. Now, there is only one name given unto salvation, and we must know that name. So the simple yet intelligent question we shall ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Savior during the time He walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface of the Holy Name Bible. Also at this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It's called the divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh led the children of Israel out of Egypt, He called Moses atop Mount Sinai and showed him the tabernacle pattern in the vision. Yahweh later on instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. The pattern consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court round about. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. In this school, we show proof that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the threefold structure and function of this tabernacle pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes the pattern. Primary constitutional objectives and aims of this institute are as follows. First, to help you find and know Yahweh, our Elohim, as He really is and actually exists. Second, to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah without the distinction of race or nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. Third, to investigate the unexplained spirit law or so-called law of nature and the powers latent in man. Fourth, to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures compared to religion, psychology, philosophy, modern, practical, and occult science. 5th, to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. 6. To learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensations and ages. 7. To discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the devil, the dragon, or Satan and his demons, operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensations of time. 8. To earnestly contend for the common salvation in faith which was once delivered unto the sons or children of Yahweh. 9. To make known that Yahweh from the beginning ordained there is no other name given among men whereby man can be saved, save in the name of Yahshua the Messiah. And 10. To inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watchword is peace and our slogan is to speak the truth. Today's scripture lesson will be Exodus, the 32nd chapter, which will be read by Dr. Patrick Mutortu. But before that, we will have a prayer by Dr. Deborah Williams. May we now have our prayer.
May we all bow our hearts and minds. Heavenly Father Yahweh, we are gathered before you to learn of you as you really is and as you actually exist. Please keep us in these perilous times and keep us with you. Please circumcise our hearts that we will always be with you throughout eternity. May we all say,
Hallelujah.
Study Bible, and I will impose the true names when necessary. This is Exodus, the 32nd chapter. And when the people saw that Moses delayed to come down out of the mount, the people gathered themselves together unto Aaron and said unto him, Up, let us make us gods that which shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we wot not what is become of him. And Aaron said unto them, Break off the golden earrings which are in the ears of your wives and of your sons and of your daughters, and bring them unto me. And all the people break off of the golden earrings which were in their ears and brought them unto Aaron. And he received them at their hand, and fashioned it with a grazing tool. And after he had made it a molten calf, and they said, These be the gods, O Israel, that have brought us up out of the land of Egypt. And when Aaron saw it, he built an altar before it. And Aaron made proclamation, and said, Tomorrow it is a feast to Yahweh. And they rose early on the morrow, and offered burnt offerings, and brought peace offerings, and the people sat down to eat and to drink, and rose up to play. And Yahweh said unto Moses, Go, get thee down, for thy people which thou hast brought out of the land of Egypt have corrupted themselves. They have turned aside quickly out of the way which I have commanded them. They have made them a molten calf, and have worshipped it, and have sacrificed thereunto, and said, These be the gods, O Israel, which have brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. And Yahweh said unto Moses, I have seen this people, and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. Now therefore let me alone, that my wrath may wax hot against them, and that I may consume them, and I will make thee a great nation. And Moses besought Yahweh. He said, Yahweh his Elohim, and said, Yahweh, why doth thy wrath wax hot against thy people, which thou hast brought forth out of the land of Egypt with great power and with a mighty hand? Verse.
Wherefore should the Egyptians speak and say, For mischief did he bring them out to slay them in the mountains, and to consume them from the face of the earth? Turn from thy fierce wrath, and repent of this evil against thy people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, thy servants, to whom thou swearest by thine own self, and said it unto them, I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and as this land that I have spoken of will I give unto your seed, and they shall inherit it forever. And Yahweh repented of the evil which he thought to do unto his people. Moses turned and went down from the mount, and the two tables of the testimony were in his hand. And the tables were written on both sides, one on the one side and on the other they were written. And the tables were the work of Elohim, and the writing were the writings of Elohim graven upon the tables. And when Joshua had heard the noise of the people as they shouted, he said unto Moses, There is a noise of war in the camp. And he said, This is not the voice of them that shout for mastery, neither is it the voice of them that cry for being overcome, but the noise of them that sing do I hear. And it came to pass as soon as he came nigh unto the camp, and he saw the calf and the dancing, and Moses' anger waxed hot, and he cast the tables out of his hands and brake them beneath the mount. And he took the calf which they had made and burnt it in the fire and grounded it into powder and strawed it and strewed it upon the water and made the children of Israel drink of it. And Moses said unto Aaron, What did this people unto thee that thou hast brought so great a sin upon them? And Aaron said, Let not the anger of my master wax hot. Thou knowest the people, that they are set on mischief. And they said unto me, Make us gods, which shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we wot not what is become of him. And I said unto him, Whosoever hath any gold, let him break it off. So they gave it me, and I cast it into the fire, and up came out this calf. And when Moses saw the people were naked, for Aaron had made them naked unto their shame amongst their enemies, then Moses stood at the gate of the camp and said, Who is on Yahweh's side? Let him come unto me. And all the sons of Levi gathered themselves together unto him. And he said unto them, Thus saith Yahweh Elohim of Israel, Put every man his sword up by his side, and go in and out from gate to gate throughout the camp, and slay every man his brother, and every man his companion, and every man his neighbor. And the children of Levi did according to the word of Moses, and there fell of the people that day about 3,000 men. For Moses said, Consecrate yourselves today to Yahweh, even every man upon his son, and upon his brother, that he may bestow upon you a blessing this day. And it came to pass on the morrow that Moses said unto the people, Ye have sinned a great sin, and now I will go up unto Yahweh preadventure, that I make an atonement for your sin. And Moses returned unto Yahweh and said, Oh, this people have sinned a great sin, and have made them gods of gold. Yet now, if thou wilt forgive their sin, and if not, blot me, I pray thee, out of thy book which thou hast written. And Yahweh said unto Moses, Whosoever hath sinned against me, him will I blot out of my book. Therefore now go lead the people unto the place which I have spoken unto thee. Behold, mine angel shall go before thee. Nevertheless, in the day which I visit, I will visit their sin upon them. And Yahweh plagued the people because they have made the calf which Aaron made. And that was Exodus, the 32nd chapter.
For our first speaker this evening, it's a pleasure to call Dr. Casey Jones.
Just thankful to be here. I don't have much on my mind right now, but I always first want to start with giving all praise to Yahweh Elohim through his son Yahshua Messiah. And just coming in on the end of that scripture lesson, was just ask him to lead and guide me and choose, you know, use me as a vessel. Building this children of Israel, building this golden calf, you know, it's just a great sin. Looking at something physical, you know, the children of Israel come out of Egypt, which is typifying the world as it is, because Egypt had many gods, you know, and it wasn't until Yahshua really led them out here. They got around this mount, and Yahweh told them how he wanted to be worshipped, and he said, "Put no graven images."
That's
and we mean. Had that read.
This is Exodus 20, and I will start at 3. "Thou shalt have no other Elohims beside me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image, or any likeness of anything that is in the heaven above, that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, Yahweh, thy Elohim, am a jealous Elohim, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children until the third and fourth generation of them that hate me."
All right, so I mean, that's self-explanatory right there. You know, he doesn't want any graven images, and that's what the children of Israel did. They built this golden calf, Apis the bull. They built that and started worshiping that, which was, he didn't like that. He doesn't like that. So that really goes to anything. You putting that before Yahweh, worshiping that, is you don't want to do that. Cause punishment. What happened in that scripture lesson? 3,000 men died. You know, so he don't play. You know, so don't put nothing before Yahweh. He's a jealous El, as just was said. You know, so that's what I take from that. And it's going on right now in this world today, up to date. You know, you can see people worshiping people, you know, and you always want to give, your honor to Yahweh Elohim before anything else. You know, this is a physical, this is physical, this is nothing. You can melt that. Just like they did, they melt that, you know. So, and Yahshua, you know, he has grace and mercy, you know. He knows us, you know. He knows what we face, you know, and he'll bring you through whatever you're going through, you know. Trials and tribulations. Can we have that read? It's in Revelations to say you will face trials and tribulations. Mm-hmm. And you just got to stay strong and keep your mind on Yahweh. And he'll get you through it, you know? Mm-hmm. I don't know exactly where that is in Revelations, but it says you will go through trials and tribulations. And they melt this down, and what they do, they when they built that tabernacle, this was gold, and he showed how he wanted to be worshipped, building this tabernacle. These items in here were gold. Mm-hmm. And we had it read in Revelation?
It's 2:10, Revelation.
Okay.
"Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life.
Right, you know, and that's beautiful, you know, because we go through it down here. I go through it myself, you know, I go through it myself, and I just have to stay patient and wait on Yahshua the Messiah and go to him whenever I'm facing something that I don't see no way out of. I just go to Yahshua the Messiah. Where is that in Exodus where it says, stand still and see the salvation? Can we have that written? Because I've been noticing, like, I watch the news and stuff, and this guy, Donald Trump, you all know him. You know, all know him. But I say, he ain't nothing but another devil. Yeah. He ain't nothing but another devil, self-exalted. And the devil was self-exalted, say he wanted to be like the Most High, and he'll be like the Most High. But what happened to him? He got cast down. And I think the same thing is just repeating itself. They said, I seen on the news one time, they said that he had a, Donald Trump, he got in a hotel, he got it built in solid gold or something like that. I'm like, wow. He got a room, solid gold. I said, that ain't nothing but the golden calf again. And people all crowded around him. You know, they worshiping the man. They don't care nothing about his policies, how crazy they are. You know, and they give me, it's nothing but this all over again, worshiping the golden calf. And I love that when I heard that scripture lesson being read, it said is children of Israel was a stiff-necked people. And that's exactly what you had today. Yahshua has done this before, showed you he don't want no graven images. You worshiping graven images. That could be a person. You know, people look at somebody with a lot of money or a rich person and say, oh man, I want to be like him because, you know, he got this, he got that, he got that. They idolizing these things. These things are nothing. These are things of the earth. You know, where is that scripture where it said that Yahshua said, build your treasures in heaven and not here on earth? Because up here, you see right here, Elohim, right here with the tabernacle, and the earth is under his feet. It's the footstool. The earth is his footstool. Yeah. So, and it's the devil's kingdom. Can we add everything? I don't know where that's. Yeah.
Okay. Exodus 14, I'm sorry, 13. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not, stand still and see the salvation of Yahweh, which he will show to you today. For the Egyptians whom ye have seen today, ye shall see them no more forever.
And that was beautiful because he took the Egyptians out of here. They washed up. Now, the children of Israel, they resurrected unto life. And the Egyptians resurrected unto death. So that goes to show you. You know, that's a prime example.
The other scripture is Matthew 6:19.
Can we add that, Rick?
Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon the earth, where moths and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. Lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also.
Yeah, so, I mean, I love that, you know, because it puts things in its proper perspective that you shouldn't get caught up on these physical things out here in the world, you know, and trying to worship somebody because of some material. These things have nothing. It's nothing. You know, I mean, it's temporary, you know. I mean, give credit to Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua the Messiah, who is in you and has power over all things and set all things under his feet. You know? So I'm just grateful, really, just to be here, you know. I'm grateful that Yahweh is still allowing me to come down here and learn of Him. And I'm just thankful for the blessings. You know, I still face my trials and tribulations just like everybody. You know, it's funny. I was listening, one day I was listening to one of Dr. Kennelly transcripts, and he was talking to the people, and he said, he like, you know why you going through what you going through? And everybody was like, why? He like, you got a mortal body, you know? Right. That's why you going right. through what you mm-hmm. going through,
right.
you know? So this is about immortality with Yahshua the Messiah. That's why mm-hmm. I love this school, because it's going beyond the physical mm-hmm. to something spiritual, which is greater, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. So that's pretty much... I yield the floor because I was just... Did I have any more?
You did. Yeah. 1 Corinthians 4, I'll start at 3. But if I... I'm sorry, 2 Corinthians 4:3. Mm-hmm. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of the Messiah, who is the image of Elohim, should shine unto them.
Was that the one you want? You want the treasures, put your treasures in.
They read that.
Yeah. Okay, great.
You know, this is a beautiful gospel, mm-hmm. this here. This is a beautiful gospel, you know, from beginning to end. Mm-hmm. And Yahshua the Messiah, he knows, he is the Alpha and Omega. He knows the beginning and end, mm-hmm. you know. I mean, that's beautiful. Moses seen the beginning, and John on the Isle of Patmos, he confirmed. This is a confirmation right here, mm-hmm. you know. So, Yahshua the Messiah is meant to be praised, and I'm just thankful, you know, that He's allowed me to take part, you know, and learning of this gospel. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not saying that I have it all together, because I don't. You know, I don't have it all together, you know, and I'm still learning. And I'm just grateful for that, you know, mm-hmm. because I could have been out of here a long time ago. And, you know, I think back on that situation that I was in, almost getting killed, getting shot in Chicago, mm-hmm. you know, and man, and when Yahshua say, he is the door. He ain't lying on that. He can't lie. He ain't lying. Because that door being open was the only way that I was able to escape them gunshots. You know, so sometimes he'll straighten you up. If you out there, you think you're going to do what you want to do, and right. you ain't going to pay no attention to Yahshua, you know. Mm-hmm. Right. He'll straighten you up real quick mm-hmm. and get you right back off in there. Mm-hmm. He'll straighten you up real quick. Mm-hmm. He is not to be played with. Just like we said, fear Yahweh. Mm-hmm. He is not to be played with.
That's right.
So with all those words, if anybody got anything out of that, all praise go to Yahweh Elohim, through His Son Yahshua Messiah, and I yield the floor.
Out of whatever you're thinking about, and keep you in class and bring you back in class, because I know he is the only reason why I'm able to get up and continue to come to class. You know, it's funny when you realize that you don't have that kind of that kind of power to do something consistently all the time.
Right.
You know, it's something way more than you doing that. Mm-hmm. And that's the spirit of Yahshua. And that's what I'm thankful for, because there's a lot of stuff going on. And, you know, even my daughter, she comes and asks me questions and stuff, and he has to give me the words to be able to, you know, tell her and things of that nature. So, you know, we got a lot going on down here, but we got a sure thing in Yahshua the Messiah, because after Yahshua gave me the words to talk to her, you know, she was more relaxed and everything else, and we were just able to go about our day, you know. So I praise Yahshua all the time, you know, things like that. And let's get the scripture lesson when they built that golden calf. You know, because this right here is very important, because this was right after they come up out of Egypt, after being delivered from Pharaoh down here, and all of those, and they were down there with all of those false idols and things of that nature, and they come out here to the wilderness. You see, before receiving this. The law that Moses received up here in his mouth, they go and build a golden calf. Can we get that?
Where do you want to start?
I don't know. Pick a place.
First verse?
Sure. Nice. Pick a place.
I just want to get that reference.
When the people saw that Moses delayed to come down out of the mount, the people gathered themselves together unto Aaron and said unto him, Up! Make us deities that may go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that hath brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we wot not what is become of him.
Now, you would think that, and these people there, they carnal minded, you know, they hadn't received the spirit of Yahshua the Messiah at this point in time, you see. And that's why they had to have this law around Yahweh, or being brought out by Yahweh. They had to receive his law. But they were carnal-minded people, and coming out of Egypt wasn't a task that one man could perform. Coming out of Egypt, there was an army down here that kept them, and a pharaoh down here that kept them bound to grievous labor and things of that nature. You see, building treasure cities and things of that nature, and not one of them could raise up and deliver the entire children of Israel out of Egypt, you see. Not one of them, you see. It was at a specific point in time that Yahweh Elohim, you see, which was told to Abraham, you see, that they would come down, you see, but they would come out, you see, with great substance, you see. And that substance is the spirit, or is Yahweh Elohim, because he's the only one, you see, that was able to bring them up out of Egypt. And see, if we look at that, and we always say this is a spiritual and psychological trek, migration, we look at this Egypt, it means darkness or confusion, you see, or chaos, you see. And they're down here, and they're in chaos, and they're in bondage, you see, and they're crying out, you see, to the one that said that, look, he said that we're going to come out of here. We're going to have to come out of here, you see. So they were sitting here waiting to be delivered out of Egypt. And the only one that could do it is Yahweh Elohim through Joshua, son of Yahshua the Messiah, you see. And if this is like into our hearts and minds, and there's chaos, confusion, and bondage going on down here, then the only one, you see, that can bring you out of that state and condition in your heart and mind would have to be Yahshua the Messiah, you see, or Yahweh Elohim. And that right there is just looking at the children of Israel, how they came out here and straightway forgot or looked past who brought them out, is something that can be done, you see, even when you are attending one of these classes, you see, because you can be brought out of that state of condition as far as not knowing who Yahweh is, not knowing who Yahshua is, you see, and then going about
going out into the world like, oh, that's that class, and mm-hmm. and that's what we learned over there, and it was all right, but now I'm about to go back to church. You see, rearing up this golden calf, you see, that they had already down here in this land of Egypt, you see, a false idol, you see, in your heart and mind, you see, you come to class, you see, you learn something, you see, mm-hmm. and then you leave, and then you build up another false idol, the mm-hmm. same one that was in that heart and mind the first time, you mm-hmm. see, now what, that Egypt or chaos and confusion, you mm-hmm. see, and that is not something that we want to do, you see. See, we have to wait, you see, and that's the one thing that they didn't do down here. They did not wait, you see, for that law, you see. You see, you have to be patient and wait on that spirit of Yahshua the Messiah to fill your heart and mind, you see, so that you do not make these golden calves and golden images, you see. And that right, receiving the Holy Spirit is the only thing that'll keep these false images out of your heart and mind, because you can't do it. You want, you recognize in your soul that you know that you need something that's more powerful than you, and something that can help you deal with things that you're going through and all this other carnal stuff. You know, you recognize that, you know, and that's the reason why you build up these false images and false ideas of God and things of that nature. You see, which, you know, not like you building it up on your own, but we've been taught all these things, and that stuff has to be cast out. You know, so they come up out of here and they build this golden calf. And if you look at Donald Trump, that's in office, and you can see that people have built themselves up another golden calf. You see, they're looking at him for having a lot of money, which this thing is, you see, it was golden. You see, it was valuable. You see, and bullheaded. You so he had a bullhead. You know, so. You know, they look in the rear of the same false image, you see. That is a false image, you see. You cannot be looking towards man, you see, to bring you comfort. You see, you can't be looking to man to do that, because a man can't do that. Man can't bring you comfort physically or spiritually and psychologically. You see, all things are given by Yahweh Elohim, you see. All things. And and see, and that's what they were doing. I was looking up some stuff. Well, actually, I wasn't looking up some stuff. I was talking about one point in time where it's simple things that that come into your mind that, you know, even Yahshua dispelled those things, or he just, you know, shows you things about that. Like I was looking at corn, and then I was in the scripture, it was talking about the corn of the threshing floor and stuff like that. And I was like, well, how did they have corn over there at that point in time, and, you know, finding out that corn is it's a hybrid, they you know, mix two things together in order to make that particular vegetable or whatever. And then I did some research on that and just found out that the word corn was used loosely as wheat, and when it was translated, that word was put in there. And then you'll find some work in John where he talks about a corn of wheat. And just corn just means grain. And I was like, oh, okay. That was simple. And then I was looking up like a diet stuff and stuff like that. And it was talking about stay away from bread. Now, the first thing that came to my mind is bread of life. You know, I'm thinking about Yahshua. I'm thinking, don't say stay away from bread. You know? But after, I'm like, how is it? You know, I let Yahshua answer those questions. You know what I'm saying? Because I can't do nothing but form a concept theory or opinion around it. But I waited, and then I had read, looking up some stuff, and found that the wheat had been changed a long time ago. The wheat had been changed. You know, it's the same thing they did with the corn. They had to make a hybrid in order to, you know, prevent famines and things of that nature. So that's why they tell you to stay away from it, because it produces a lot of glucose, which is bad for the body. And if you think about it, you know, now you got false bread out here. You got bread out here that's not really good for the body. It looks like bread, but it's not the original bread. You see, it's not the bread of life. That stuff is damaging for the body. And, you know, you look at that spiritually and psychologically, And then you realize, you know, if this is the true bread, Yahshua the Messiah, the true bread. See, that is the source and the substance, you see. And then you got to have hybrid or that false bread. You know, you got to have popes and you got to have preachers and things of that nature. And, you know, it don't matter which one you get. You can get the ones with all the little grains and stuff like that, but it's still made from the same wheat. So if you look at these guys, you know, it don't matter what they're talking about. They can be talking good. They can be talking all that. It's all puffed up. You see, it's coming from the same doctrine, you see. So it don't matter, you know. And then I was looking at the water and stuff like that. And then, you of course, you know how bad the water is and stuff like that, and how we're not even consuming that properly. So it's like, man, can we get that one scripture where it talks about in those days there'd be a famine, not for bread and for water, but for the word, hearing of the word. It takes natural things to understand spiritual things, mm-hmm. you know. And there's a lot of people out here, myself included, you know, you eat bread, you drink the water, and you think you're getting some good stuff, you know. But it ain't the true bread, and it ain't good water. The true bread is Yahshua, mm-hmm. and the true water is the gospel, is the preaching of the gospel. You see, we're talking about spiritually and psychologically. See, so you got to have good bread and good water naturally. So then you have to have good bread and good water spiritually and psychologically. So
Amos 8 and 11. Behold, the days come, said Yahweh Elohim, that I will send a famine in the land, mm-hmm. not a famine of bread nor a thirst for water, mm-hmm. but of hearing the words of Yahweh.
Right. Not a famine for bread or thirst for water, but for the hearing, you see, of the words of Yahweh, the word of Yahweh, you see. And these are small classes, you know. And, you know, people just don't want to consume this thing, you know. People don't want to take this in, you know. There's so much false doctrine out there. There's so much stuff just to make you feel good. It's that false bread. The false bread, it tastes good. It's nice and sweet, you know. It's pleasing to the taste buds, but it's not good for the body. You know, you hear those Joel Osteens and bigger, you know, big old preachers and stuff like that, and they preaching all this nice stuff. You know, God's going to bless you, and He's going to put so many thousands of dollars in your pocket. Oh, and it tastes real good. You take that in, it tastes good. But it's false doctrine. It's not good. You see, it's not good for the soul.
Yeah.
You see, there's good food and there's bad food, you see. And if these mysteries are going side by side down the ages and dispensations, and this one says He's going to be like the Most High, you see, then it's going to almost look like it. It's going to almost look like it, you see. It's going to appear to be something like it, you see. Mm-hmm. But, you know, but Yahshua, He has definitely revealed these things to His sons, you see. And that's the most important thing, you know, because if you can't discern false doctrine, then, you know, you're going to be subject to that terrible food. You see, mm-hmm. Yahshua has given us a good diet ever since we've been in this class. He got us up off the junk food.
That's right.
You see, even the stuff that we think that we still being cleaned up, the mm-hmm. stuff that we still like to take in and things of that nature, but He got to show us, hey, that can make you sick. Mm-hmm. That stuff can disease the heart and mind and the brain, and he's got to take that stuff away from you. He got mm-hmm. to show you what a good diet is. It's death, burial, and resurrection of Yahshua the Messiah. That's the gospel. That is a good diet. Mm-hmm. Because that's that same death, burial, and resurrection, the same principles, you see, it's the same thing, that same Yahshua, you see, Yahweh Elohim that brought in the creation, you see, according to a pattern. You see, this death, burial, resurrection is the pattern. That's that good food from the natural source and substance. Not that He's natural, I'm just saying from the source and substance. You see? And that's what we need. We need it from the original source and substance. That is the only thing that's good for the soul. And we got that in Yahshua the Messiah. That good food, you see? That good bread, that good wine, that good water, you see? Our soul, it's a good thing. It's a good thing for us, you see. And I'm pretty sure we know that personally, but it will be revealed just how much, just how sweet it is, just how good it is, you know, to be in this gospel. You see, even though that, you know, we labor to come here, you know, in our physical body, Yahshua got to drag us and get us here, you know, but, you know, it's definitely going to pay off. And it's paying off now, if you realize it, you know, because even though things are going on, even though it's a lot of turmoil out here, we're not really shaking and quaking like that. We're not out here trying to beat people over the head and tell them, Trump is bad. And we're trying to protest all this other type of stuff. He don't got us in that kind of chaos and confusion. You see, he's, you know, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, as Paul put it. You see, you know, you just, you know, keep it straight. Death, Yahshua Messiah, burial, resurrect the third day according to the scriptures. You keep it plain and simple like that, you know, not, you know, simple names. It's been proven, you see, that you can find anywhere, Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua, not Lord God and Jesus Christ, you see. Those are hybrids, you see. Those are just that false food, you see. You take that stuff in there and then you're going to have all kind of diseases in the heart and mind coming from that. You see, malnutrition, you know, lack of knowledge, heart and mind, you see, and whatever you have faith in based on that can crumble, and that's your health, that is your health, and that just crumbles when you don't got the proper stuff on you. So, and that's really, you know, all I have to say. It was the only thing that was on my mind a little bit, so that being said, I'm glad you
did.
I thought he read it.
I read it. Okay, with that being said, I'm going to yield the floor.
Hallelujah.
For our next speaker, it's a pleasure to call Dr. Deborah Williams.
Good afternoon. Good evening.
Good evening.
Really enjoyed the remarks of the previous speakers, and I too will not be up here long. Been out of town a couple of weekends, you know. Got a lot going on. Can I have Deuteronomy 13 chapter? Can you start at one? Because it's coming down here. You know, as the previous speaker said, we have truly been blessed. He led us down here to the living water. We didn't even know what living water was. You know, we were led down here. You know, he brought us in. I also want the scripture, I think it's the 7th chapter of Deuteronomy, that he cast his love upon us. I want that also.
You said you wanted Deuteronomy 13 and 1?
Yeah, come on down.
What, sorry, 1?
Right.
Deuteronomy 13 and 1. If there arise among you a prophet or a dreamer of dreams, and giveth thee a sign or a wonder.
Right.
And the sign or wonder can come to pass thereof. He spake unto thee, saying, let us go after other Elohim, which thou hast not known, and let us serve them. Thou shalt not hearken unto the words of that prophet or that dreamer of dreams. For Yahweh, your Elohim, proveth you to know whether you love Yahweh, your Elohim, with all your heart, with all your soul.
That's it. That's it. Because he proveth us to, you know, read that again. And I also want where it says, in Deuteronomy, where it says, thou shalt love Yahweh thy Elohim with all thy heart and with all thy soul. Because it's coming down here that we will, you know, when we came in, we were introduced to the names, okay? Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua. We found out that Lord is not a name, it's a title. God is not a name, it's a title. And Jesus Christ is an erroneous name. We was introduced to the tabernacle. Tabernacle is threefold. We were told that he is a unity and not a trinity. That the tabernacle is a court roundabout, holy place, most holy place. And it just blew my mind when it came in. You know, it took me a long time to get this. Elohim, the archetype original pattern of the universe. That he's a pattern. Mm-hmm. That he's threefold, but one. He is the Father, Yahweh in the abstract state, no shape and form, invisibility. He took on the shape and form in part, not in totality, as the Word or Son. This is Yah super incorporeal, but like it says in the Elohim book, he transmuted. This is a super incorporeal shape and form of a man, and then later manifested in a physical body. Deuteronomy 6 and 4 says, Yahweh our Elohim is Yahweh a unity. He's not three separate entities. This is spirit that has the power to transmute into the incorporeal and then into a physical body and walk the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah. And that's mind-blowing in itself. You know, it's mind-blowing to me to find out that that was the creator of heaven and earth. That wasn't no ordinary man. They nailed on that cross. That was the creator of heaven and earth. You know, so now we come down here and we hear him speak from the mount in vessels. See, preach this gospel according to the law and the prophets. And you know, as you come and you sit, after a while, you realize was that Philip that said, where should I go? Because thou hast the words to eternal life. Mm-hmm. You know, and as you said, you know, when you come down here, you realize that he do all the work. You can't do this on your own.
That's right.
As it was previously said, you can get scripture to prove that. See, give me a... can you go back to what I asked?
You have to...
Do you want me to reread 13? Or?
Yeah, reread 13.
All right. Deuteronomy 13. If there arise among you a prophet or a dreamer of dreams, and giveth thee a sign or a wonder, and the sign or the wonder come to pass thereof, he spake unto thee, saying, let us go after other Elohim, which thou hast not known, and let us serve him. Them. Thou shalt not hearken unto the words of that prophet or that dreamer of dreams.
That's right.
For Yahweh your Elohim proveth you to know whether ye love Yahweh your Elohim with all your heart and with all your soul.
Right. Now, coming down here, we find out that this migration goes by the pattern too. It's threefold. It's Egypt, wilderness, Canaan's land. We find that the children of Israel... Paul said that all these things happened to them as an example. See, that the children of Israel, that he came down, he gave Abraham a promise. He told them, told Abraham, first he told him that he would, give me that. I don't want to mess it up. Every time.
You want 6 and 5?
Yeah.
Thou shalt love Yahweh thy Elohim with all thine heart, and with all thine soul.
That's right.
And with all thy might.
Mm-hmm. Now, how do you do that? Mm-hmm. How do you do that? Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? When we come down here, we find out that the children of Israel, as the previous speaker said, they was brought through the divided waters of the Red Sea. They was told, I'm getting ahead of myself, give me Abraham first, where they was told that their seed would have to go down into the land of Egypt, but then they would be bought up. Mm-hmm. Give me that first.
Exodus 15:13. Mm-hmm. And he said unto Abram, know for surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them. And they shall afflict them 400 years.
And they shall afflict them, see. And we can look at this coming down here. That this, we're drawing, we're extracting principles out of this. See, this land of Egypt that they was in was darkness, ignorance, and confusion. And they were afflicted by the Egyptians. Now, we keep coming in here as you sit and you hear this preached. Then at some point it dawns on you. This is where I came from. Mm-hmm. We were in the world. Mm-hmm. I was listening to Syracuse. And they was talking about water. And the three states of water in the ocean. The deepest part of the ocean is the abyss. Very little life exists down there. And it's the biggest part. Oh boy, I'm like, wow, now that's deep. You see what I'm saying? It's the deepest part, and it's the biggest part. See, and we can see that in the world as a type and a shadow. You see what I'm saying? This is where we were drawn out from, in the deep darkness, or Egypt.
And also that nation whom they shall serve will I judge. And afterwards shall they come out with great substance.
Afterwards say they come out with great substance. So the children of Israel did go down by a famine. They went down into the land of Egypt, Joseph being the forerunner. They go down into the land of Egypt. Joseph dies off. There's a Pharaoh that raised up that knows not Joseph. They end up in bondage. They're down here some 400 years. And they're brought up by a mighty hand. They're brought up by the principle of blood. They had to slay that lamb, take of the blood, put it on the upper lintel, two side posts, and dip from the base in the blood. Mm-hmm. They come up by blood. They go through the divided waters of the Red Sea. They're led by a cloud. Blood, water, spirit. And that's how we come up. Through the preaching of the gospel, which is blood, water, spirit. Coming on up out of the land of Egypt. Now, they come out here. They, as the scripture lesson says, they come out here. Moses goes in the mount for 40 days. He received his second trip into the mount. He's up there for 40 days. He's seeing a vision in the mount, and they say, well, he delayed his coming. So what they did is they build a golden calf and say, come, let right. Help me out.
Let
us see the God. Remember, he's kind of shot right now. Yeah. Let this be the gods that brought us up out of the land of Egypt. See? So now we come into class. Joshua is important. Let me bring this out. Joshua, the son of Nun. Coming into class, we find out that Joshua, the son of Nun, appeared in the land of Egypt around 30, age 30. He was down there with them. And he saw their afflictions. See, it was coming into class that we find out that Joshua, the son of Nun, actually was Yahshua the Messiah back then. Give me 1 Corinthians 10:1. It's a lot of mysteries that has been revealed to us through the preaching of the gospel. And coming down here, we realize that all this is a vision given to a man, Henry Clifford Kinley, in the year 1931. He had a divine vision accompanied by a divine revelation.
1 Corinthians 10:1. Moreover, brethren, I would not that ye should be ignorant that how that all our fathers were under the cloud and all passed through the sea.
Mm-hmm.
And all were baptized under Moses in the cloud and in the sea.
Mm-hmm.
And did all eat the same spiritual meal.
Mm-hmm.
And all did drink the same spiritual drink.
Mm-hmm.
For they drank of that spiritual rock that led them.
Mm-hmm.
And the rock was the Messiah.
And that rock was the Messiah. So it's Joshua the son of Nun that takes Moses up into the mount. They have him painted right here on the chart. And it's Joshua the son of Nun that tells Moses
mm-hmm.
about the noise mm-hmm. in the camp and what they're doing. See? So what we find out when we come down here is that this thing overturns and it overturns and it overturns. They couldn't do no more. First of all, the Holy Spirit wasn't in them. So they didn't have the love of Yahweh in them. They didn't have the Holy Spirit in them. And this thing is repeating itself. It overturns. They couldn't do no more than what their forefathers did. Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. Eve was deceived by the serpent. Okay? We come down here and we find out that there is a devil.
Mm-hmm.
There is a devil. And he's doing his job down here. His job is to deceive. See? Now, it was Joshua the son of Nun that brings them up out of the land of Egypt. The old heads, they come into the wilderness. The old heads die off here in the wilderness. And it's the new birth that goes over. I won't Joshua 5 and 3.
Mm.
Moses dies off here in the wilderness. Joshua, or the son of Nun, is the one that actually takes them over into Canaan's land. See?
Joshua 5 and 3.
Yeah, I know I'm cutting this up.
And Joshua made him sharp knives and circumcised the children of Israel at the hill of the foreskin.
Right.
And this is the cause why Joshua did circumcise
right.
all the people that came out of Egypt that were males, even all the men that died in the wilderness, by the way, after they came up out of Egypt.
Okay. So now you got Joshua the son of Nun. Now that's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing that he's Joshua the Messiah.
Mm-hmm.
Back there with him. He's the one. See, we come down here and as the Messiah told Nicodemus, you must be born again. So it's the new birth. When we come in here and the gospel is preached to us, see, that's shaping and forming us. That old man has to die,
mm-hmm.
see, and we must be born again. And that's the circumcision made without hands. Give me Deuteronomy 30 and 6. That's the circumcision made without hands, done as it was back here by Joshua the son of Nun. He was the one that circumcised the new birth going into Canaan's land. Now we down here, as we come and hear this gospel preached, this is a circumcision made without hands. The cutting away of the flesh. The circumcision from a natural standpoint is the cutting away of the foreskin,
mm-hmm.
revealing the hand.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we come and we sit and we listen. It's him that's doing that spiritual operation
mm-hmm.
on us. It's not of ourselves. Deuteronomy 30 and 6.
And Yahweh thy Elohim will circumcise thy heart.
Yeah.
And the heart of thy seed
mm-hmm.
to love Yahweh thy Elohim.
To love Yahweh thy Elohim.
With all thy heart.
With all thine heart.
And with all thine soul.
And with all thy soul, with all our heart, he has to do that. We can't do that. It's a spiritual operation going on down here. Go ahead.
That thou mayest live.
That we may live. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? As he told the bones in Ezekiel, can these dry bones live? That we may live. He's the one that's doing this. This is truly by grace. 1 Corinthians 15:1-4. This is truly by grace and by mercy. So we can see that and look back and say, well, you know what? They didn't have the Holy Spirit. They couldn't love him. You see what I'm saying? But look, now the Messiah comes in. He says he's doing the will of the Father. Mm-hmm. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Mm-hmm. It's him in us, mm-hmm. see, that keeps us in the way. Just like that cloud did, bringing them up out of Egypt. You see what I'm saying? It kept them in the way, see. And it's Yahshua the Messiah in us. Other than that, you can't do it. Just like they couldn't do it back here, all that happened to them as examples. Just like the world can't do it. See, there's no way we could, like you say, keep his words. No way. We are saved by grace through faith. See? And it's the foolishness of preaching. We come down here, we hear this gospel, and we believe. See? And as the devil tried to test the Messiah, as they was tempted out there in the wilderness, as he tried to test the Messiah to, give me that, Matthew 4th chapter. Mm-hmm. We can see what he's doing in us.
This is Matthew 4:1. And then was Yahshua led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil.
Because he's fulfilling. We came down here and we was told that he was fulfilling. The word fulfill means to complete, to bring to an end, to perform. Mm-hmm. See, the script was already written for him. Mm-hmm. It was already written. Go ahead.
And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward hungry. Mm-hmm. And when the tempter came to him, he said, if thou be the Son of Yahweh, command these stones to be made bread. Uh-huh. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of Yahweh.
That's right. Man does not live by bread alone, but by every word mm-hmm. that proceedeth mm-hmm. out of the mouth of Yahweh. Mm-hmm. See? Mm-hmm. Now there's a scripture that says, I found thy words and I did eat them. Mm-hmm. See, it's him in us, bringing back to our remembrance whatsoever he has said, mm-hmm. keeping us in the way. Mm-hmm. See, we can't do this. We just can't do this on our own. Mm-hmm. See, that's why we give him the glory, the honor, and the praise. Because he supposed to have it.
That's right.
He's supposed to have
that's
it.
Right.
You know, sometimes I look and I'm like, wow, we don't even keep our heartbeat. We don't even do that. You see what I'm saying? I mean, he's an awesome man. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
And the devil taketh him up to a holy mm-hmm. city and setteth him on a pinnacle of the temple mm-hmm. and said unto him, if thou be the Son of Yahweh, cast thyself down, for mm-hmm. it is written, he shall give his angels charge concerning thee, mm-hmm. and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou shalt dash thy foot against the stone.
And I like how it was always said, now you know that's some nerve. Mm-hmm. Now he know who cast him out of heaven. Mm-hmm. He knew who he was. Mm-hmm. And he asked him to bow down to him. Mm-hmm. How much more for us? Mm-hmm. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yahshua said unto him, it is written again, thou shalt not tempt Yahweh thy Elohim.
So the Messiah kept going back to the law and the prophets. Mm-hmm. See, because he came to do the will of his Father. See, he came to do the will of his Father. And if it's him in us, that is what's going to keep us in the way. Can I have that scripture? Can't no creature separate us from the love? Mm-hmm. See, from the love of the Messiah. See, now that scripture.
Who shall separate us from what shall tribulation and distress?
Right. Shall tribulation and shall distress. Mm-hmm. You know, just give a little brief testimony. Came to class one day. Last year was really, really rough. Okay, like you say, the trials and the tribulations. You know, came to class one day. Got on the elevator all of a sudden. Because sometimes to talk to you, you ain't even thinking about it. Mm-hmm. You know, getting on the elevator to go down, he said, who do you think brought you through that? Some of these trials is long.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? They long.
Yeah.
What would cause you not to just throw your hands up? You know what? What would cause you not to be tired? Hmm. And to go through it? What causes you to go through a storm? Because the average person, I don't like storms. They definitely don't want to go through one. You see what I'm saying? Right. But what would cause you? He's awesome. Mm-hmm. Like he say, he's there and he's working. Like he say, he's there when you got a bad day. Sometimes you have a whole year that's bad. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But that's some power to keep you standing. Go ahead.
Romans 8:35. Who shall separate us from the love of the Messiah? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long.
That's right.
We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us.
Through him that loved us. Right. See, it wasn't that we loved him. Right. He loved us. Mm-hmm. And that's something that you just can't. I mean, you sit here. You're here. See, Yahweh so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. You see what I'm saying? There's no way. There's just no way for us to stand. Even when they say put on the whole armor of Yahweh. The whole armor is him. Feet shod with the preparation of the gospel. You see what I'm saying? The shield of faith. You see what I'm saying? This thing is just, it's just beautiful. We wasn't there when he created the creation. Wasn't no man beside him. He did that by himself. He fulfilled the law and the prophets by himself. And truly, he's keeping us. You see what I'm saying? This is really, you know, as you say, you look at the world out there, and it's really sad, you know, when you try to talk to people and, you know, come to class. They don't see any value in it. Mm-hmm. And as he was talking the day I was talking to my son, me and him was talking about the gospel, and he said the same thing. Yahweh don't play. See, you don't turn your back on him. You know, just count this as nothing. You know, trodden underfoot the Son of Man, who has done everything for us, you know, and then turn around and give that glory to a golden calf, or as they said, to a man, to yourself.
Right.
You know, look what I did. I mean, you know, and then, look, and even just the simple stuff, to realize that you don't keep yourself, you don't keep your heart beating. Let it stop, or have a heart, you know, start acting up. People start praying in.
That's right.
See, they get a heart attack, they have a heart attack, or they heart acting up, they ain't running the truck. You see what I'm saying? They try to find what? A doctor. You see what I'm saying? It's just a mess. It's just how, see how far man is away. You know, and how these false prophets, like you said, has come along and said that just keeping the world bound on the flesh. You know, God gonna send me a husband. God bless me. I hear people, God bless me, I got a house. You see what I'm saying? Without realizing what the true blessing is. It's not your house, it's not your car, it's not your, you see what I'm saying?
That's right.
It's to have it's to know him. Mm-hmm. Really? Sum it up. It's to know him. Mm-hmm. And that he has to reveal to you. We're not smart enough to go into that Bible and figure this out on our own. It's just not going to happen. If you read it day and night, it's just not going to happen. See, you got people to go to school for that. Like you say, seminary school, and they can't figure out he fulfilled. Mm-hmm. And that's the Bible is a tool they use.
Yes.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? That's a tool they use. Mm-hmm. And they ain't figured it out yet. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? I mean, this thing is simple. Once he opened your understanding to it, it's simple. The difference between institution and fulfill. It's simple, but it has to be revealed. Mm-hmm. These are his mysteries, that he loved us so much that he brought us down here, had us sit in the chair. Because when I know me, when I first came down here, I'm looking at the charts and I didn't understand what was being said. You know, most of the time when you don't understand something, you just get up and walk out. You know, but he got to catch you with something. Mm-hmm. He got to throw something, you know, that bait. Yeah. Catch you with something to make you say, okay, let me sit here a little bit longer and check this out. Mm-hmm. And he knows what bait for each individual.
That's right.
You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He knows what bait for each individual to make us say, oh, okay, yeah, let me sit here. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. We serve an awesome man. It's an awesome man. And I just want to give all honor and glory to Yahshua, the Messiah. Because he is truly, truly doing all the work. All we got to do is just believe, sit back, and watch him work. Mm-hmm. said I would do a work in your day. Mm-hmm. You know. And with that, I want to yield the floor.
Hallelujah.
Our next speaker is a pleasure to call Dr. John Quiz.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I'd like to give all honor and glory to Yahshua Sai, Yahweh Elohim. I'm happy to be here. Thankful to be here, actually. Yes, what's on my heart and mind? There's something on my heart and mind. I don't know if he's gonna, if it's gonna come out. If it's his will, fine. If not, then that's okay too. All right. Give me Genesis, where it talks about the tree of life. I think it's, I don't know where it's at. Yeah, it's in Genesis. Where it said, lest they take hold of the tree of life and live. Forever. Third chapter, yeah. Well, maybe it's 3 and 8, 3 and 9, 3 and 6. I don't know where it is. It's in there somewhere. And when you get it, just let me know. All right. What's on my heart and mind is, I've been looking at this tree of life. I don't know. Yeah, give me that. Let me just get that. Okay, you got it.
And 22, I believe.
Okay, that's it.
And Yahweh Elohim said, "Behold, man is become as one of us, mm-hmm. to know good and evil, mm-hmm. and know. And now lest he put forth his hand and take also of the tree of life, mm-hmm. and eat." And live forever. Mm-hmm. Therefore, Yahweh Elohim sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from which he was taken. Mm-hmm. So he drove out the man, and he placed at the east of the Garden of Eden cherubims and a flaming mm-hmm. sword which turned every way to guard the way to the tree of life.
Mm-hmm. So Adam was given a commandment that the day that you touch of that tree, you shall surely die. So life and his life was predicated on the obedience. Of the obedience of that law, don't touch that tree of knowledge of good and evil. But we know that the commandment was broken, or Yahweh made Adam as a type and a shadow, that he would willingly give up his life for his bride. See? And because of what he did, and because of that state and condition that took place in the garden, that meant that they could not stay up in that garden, see? Because that garden represented the kingdom, it represented peace, it represented life, see? And while, or let's say, before the breaking of that law, or before that law was, before he willingly died for his bride, see, what took place, see, before that, you see, well, actually, you know, if you take a look at this, you take a look at this 6 day, you take a look at these veils right up here, see, you had the sun, you had, there was a perfect peace, see, you had on the fifth day, see, you had the birds, just look at this, you had the birds, I know you can't see it, but on this veil right here, you have the birds up in the heavens, see, and on the fourth day, you have the sun, everything is in its perfection, see, you have the sun up here. See, you have on the third day, you have the trees in fruition. See, you have Adam and Eve just relaxing, and everything's pretty great. See, you know, everything is just pretty good. Now, what took place is after that transgression, they had to leave that state, see, and they had to work for a living, see. It was no longer, you know, given to them. They had to work, see. Now, give me, keep in mind what we're talking about, which is this tree, or we're talking about life. I'm going to skip and go all the way to, not Revelation, I'm going to skip and go all the way to John, the 11th chapter, where Mary
or Martha, or one of them, I don't know, says that if you had been here, Lazarus would not have died. Mm-hmm. See? And Yahshua Messiah is going to say, well, can you just give me that? Why am I quoting it? You can just read it. Where is it at in there? I'm not sure. But I'm trying to describe where I'm on at. Where he, anybody know where that's at?
He said, yeah, if you, this, 11:21.
Okay, good.
Then said Martha unto Yahshua, mm-hmm. Rabbi, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died.
Mm-hmm.
But I know that even now, whatsoever thou ask of Elohim,
mm-hmm.
Elohim will give it thee.
Now see, she knew that because look, now they walked around seeing, they heard of the miracles, saw some miracles, walked around, saw some miracles, people told them about some miracles, they've seen miracles. And heard what this man had done, what Yahshua Messiah had done, healed the sick, see, done everything, see. And this is why she's making this statement. Hey, if you had just been here, I know everything would have been fantastic. You know, go here.
Yahshua said unto her,
mm-hmm.
Thy brother shall rise again.
Mm-hmm.
Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection.
Now, see, that's a good enough. See, Martha said, look, I know that he'll live again in the resurrection. See, and that, you know, makes sense to say something like that. Why not say something like that? Yeah, he'll live again in the resurrection. See, go ahead.
At the last day.
At the last day.
Yahshua said unto her,
mm-hmm.
I am the resurrection.
Now, this is a very deep statement to make. He said, I am the resurrection. Now, see, this is, you know, after hearing something like this, you know, like, okay, wow. You got to prove that. You are the resurrection. And this is what he's going to do. He's going to prove. Now listen now. He's going to prove that he is the resurrection before he goes through a death, a burial, and a resurrection. All right? See, because he's life. He represents the tree of life.
Right.
That's what we're trying to get you to see. He is that tree of life. See? And how do we know that? Because he's the one walking around alive.
Right.
See, and they're eating his words.
Right.
See, go ahead.
Okay, I am the resurrection and the life.
Mm-hmm.
He that believeth in me,
mm-hmm.
though he were dead, yet shall he live.
Mm-hmm.
And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
Now wait a minute. Whosoever believeth in me shall never die. See, he's making a statement. See, if you believe in Yahshua Messiah, you shall never die.
Mm-hmm.
See, now, he's going to make this statement. He's going to resurrect Lazarus, and Lazarus is going to die.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Now, that doesn't make him alive.
Right.
See, but we got to, go ahead. We got to understand that, see, the life. Exactly. Spiritual, well, that's what we're getting to. Go ahead.
Believeth thou this?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Continue.
Yeah, continue. Mm-hmm.
And she said unto him, yea, Rabbi,
mm-hmm.
I believe thou art the Messiah,
mm-hmm.
the Son of Elohim,
mm-hmm.
which should come into the world.
Mm-hmm.
And when she had so said, she went her way and called Mary, her sister, secretly saying,
mm-hmm.
the Master is come.
Mm-hmm. Now she's going to go there and she's going to say the same thing. If you just hadn't been here, you know, this would never happen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, why didn't you come? And you know the story, because he didn't. He tarried, you know, when his disciples said, you know the story, he said he's sleeping. He said, well, he's sleeping, he's doing well. Let us go to sleep, you know, whatever, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead. Okay. Now, keep reading just a little bit more. I don't have a lot of time. I know.
As soon as she heard that,
mm-hmm.
she rose quickly and came unto him.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Yahshua was not yet coming to the town, but
mm-hmm.
was in that place where Martha met him. And
keep
the
going.
Jews mm-hmm. then, which were with her in the house, and comforted her,
mm-hmm.
when they saw Mary, that she rose up hastily and
mm-hmm.
went out, followed her, saying, she goeth unto the grave, and was there.
Mm-hmm.
And Mary was come where Yahshua was, and saw him,
mm-hmm.
and she fell down at his feet, saying unto him, Rabbi, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died.
Mm-hmm.
Yahshua therefore saw her weeping, and the Jews also weeping, which came with her.
Mm-hmm.
He groaned in his spirit, and was troubled,
mm-hmm.
and said, where have you laid him?
Mm-hmm.
And they say unto him, Master, come and see.
Mm-hmm.
Yahshua wept.
Mm-hmm.
And when then said the Jews, behold, how he loved him.
Now, go ahead, one more verse.
Then they came,
mm-hmm.
how could not this man, which opened the eyes of the blind.
See, they heard of all the things that he had done. I mean, he done a lot of stuff, so it wasn't, you know, go ahead.
which caused that even this man should not have died.
Mm-hmm.
Yahshua therefore again, groaning in himself, coming to the grave, it was a cave, and a stone lay upon it.
Mm-hmm.
Yahshua said, take away the stone. Mm-hmm. Martha, the sister of him mm-hmm. that was dead, said unto him,
mm-hmm.
Rabbi, by this time he stinketh, for mm-hmm. he's been dead 4 days.
Mm-hmm.
Yahshua said unto her, said I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, that thou shouldst see the glory of Elohim?
Mm-hmm.
Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid.
Mm-hmm.
Yahshua lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I mm-hmm. thank thee that thou hast heard me,
mm-hmm.
and I knew that thou heardest me also.
So he has the power, and I'm going to cut this short. He has the power. He calls Lazarus forth, and Lazarus comes forth from the grave, bound. And, you know, he, like I said, he was in that grave. He said, by now he's stinking. He comes for, you know, bound. He said, let him loose. See, so Yahshua said, spoke the word. See, and spoke the word and called Lazarus. Now, here's the important thing. Call Lazarus by name.
Mm-hmm.
See, he didn't say everybody resurrect right now, you know. And if anybody was somebody else, you know, as stupid as it may sound, even if there was a people, you know, a
brother's yeah. name, Lazarus.
Exactly. I mean, let's face the fact here, you know, that there's people who have more than one name.
Right.
See?
Right.
So he called Lazarus, yeah, by name.
Right.
But see, he called him by name, and that soul recognized that.
Mm-hmm.
See?
Mm-hmm.
And that soul, see? Because, see, I'll tell you what. Give me the scripture lesson where it said, him with our bottle of the book of life. See? See, here's the thing, you know, everybody's name, everybody's name is wrote in this book of life. See, now, the thing is, when we're going to read, it said, him who sinned, him would I, Yahweh said, him would I blot out of what? Of my book. See, now give me that. See, and I, you know, I'm just going to touch on this and go through this some other time. But go ahead. 32 is like the...
32.
Thank you.
Yet now, if thou wilt forgive their sin,
mm-hmm.
and if not, blot me, I pray thee, out of thy book which mm-hmm. thou hast written.
Now, wait a minute. You know, like, listen. Here's Moses saying, now, blot... Where did he see the book at? You got to stop, you know, stop and ask some questions. Where did Moses see this book at? Someone pointing up here, and this is where he said, listen, this, okay, we'll do it this way. When Moses comes up here in the second trip, see, he sees the days of creation, the 6 days, he sees the 7 day, he rested, so he sees Adam and Eve being created. And then the 33 days, this is the second trip we're talking about. On the second trip, what does he see?
Tabernacle.
33 days of what?
Tabernacle.
Of the tabernacle. That's the second trip. The third trip, he goes back up there. Now, remember now, Adam and Eve is in the garden, see, and they are what? At rest, see. Now, the third trip, he goes back up there, see, he sees that, like I said, recapitulation, see, or rerun, see, or he sees it again, see, or he sees Adam and Eve where? In the garden, see, and then he sees what? The transgression. See, he sees the transgression. And see, remember, this way he understands
why they did this.
Exactly.
Yeah.
He understands the role that Aaron plays.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
See?
Yeah.
Because he understands the role that Aaron plays. He understands the role that the children of Israel played.
Yeah.
See, he understands the golden calf.
Right.
See, he understands all of that. Because see, the same thing took place right here. Mm-hmm. See, it's the same thing. See, in type. See, that took place. See, this is a type. But see, it took place where? In the garden.
That's right.
See, so he sees the same thing. But see, that in the next 33 days, what does he see, class?
The generations.
See, of what? Of the flesh. He also sees his own birth.
Mm-hmm.
See, he's talking about there's a baby in the water. Now, wait a minute.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, this is a vision.
Mm-hmm.
He's talking about his own birth. He sees his own self being placed in the water.
Right.
All right?
Right.
You know, so see, he sees everything. See?
Right.
Now, this is the point I'm trying to make. He sees the generations coming from, listen, he sees the generations come as a type. See, I'm saying as a type. You see, the generation's coming from Adam.
Right.
You see that?
Mm-hmm.
See, as a type, see, the generation coming from that one man, Adam. See, but he also see the generations of the creation coming from the one man, Elohim.
Right.
See, everything coming from him. See, life is coming from the one who created the life.
Right.
You see that? And then we talked about the trees in fruition. That's life. We talked about the birds and what? In fruition. That's life. We talk about the sun that gives. See, as a type and a shadow, you have to have that sun to what? For life. Mm-hmm. You see that? Mm-hmm. See, he sees life coming from life, the true life.
Right.
See, the true life. The true life, see, comes, see, from him. Mm-hmm. See, right here. Mm-hmm. See, likewise, see, he comes down here and he's able to resurrect the man like it ain't nothing to it. Resurrect a man's soul like it ain't nothing to it. See, because
right.
Well, that's life. That is the tree of life.
Right.
See, now let's back this up and get some examples. But before we get this, like I said, I'm going to go through this just a little bit and go through this again another day. Now, and when he goes to, when Moses comes right here at this burning bush, see, and Yahweh calls him, he says, Moses, Moses.
Right.
See, he didn't say, well, first of all, there's a lot of things going on at this burning bush.
Mm-hmm.
See, you know, Yahweh introduced himself and introduced his name to him.
Right.
See, that's the main thing. Mm-hmm. But there's another thing that's going on at this burning bush, too. He calls Moses by his name.
Right.
See, and Moses didn't go up there and introduce himself.
Mm-hmm.
See, he didn't say, yeah, hey, I'm Moses.
Mm-hmm.
Who are you? This was not an introduction like that.
Right.
You know, it wasn't like that.
Right.
See, Yahweh knew his name. In fact, right. To make sure his doctor didn't want to take, to make sure he knew who he was talking about, he said Moses. Then to make sure he didn't misunderstand, he said Moses. See, you see what I'm saying? He exacts the word. See, look,
mm-hmm.
I know who I'm talking to.
Mm-hmm.
I know who you are.
Mm-hmm.
See, so he called him by name. See, now remember, he has to know, this is important, he has to know Moses by name. Because, see, look, we're talking about the one who's, look, has the book of life.
Right.
And everybody's name is wrote in that book.
Right.
So, see, Moses is just one of the names that are wrote in that book.
Mm-hmm.
See, you know, so get you to understand. Now, see, again, look, we want to get some more scriptures, but, you know, I'm going to cut it really short. But the thing I like to see with this is, you know, the important things is Yahweh knows your name. He knows who you are. See, he knows who I am.
Right.
See, and that's something, you know, that should be some great comfort to you.
Yeah.
That, you know, that you're not introducing yourself to him.
Yeah.
See, he's introducing himself to you.
Right.
See, because to do that, he has to know who you are.
Right.
See, and then you get to know who
he is.
See, don't get it twisted. Don't get it messed up.
Right.
See.
Right.
So that's see, and because of that, because see, your name is there. Now, he said, he who sinned him would I blot out. And now, see, that's a big statement, and the whole storyline is within that.
Mm-hmm.
He who sinned him would he blot out.
Mm-hmm.
See, now, we're going to cut this really, really short. I can't cut it too short. What did I want? I want Proverbs, I think it's 3, I'm not sure where it's at. Where it says, he who findeth me has found life. So what is that? 3 and 15? 15 and 3? I don't know. It's in there somewhere. Wisdom. It's in there. Try the 3rd chapter. What is that? I don't know. Well, here we are.
Proverbs.
Yeah, Proverbs. Anybody see it?
835 is there.
Okay, give me 835. That's not what I want, but it's in there. It's there, too.
Yeah. Here we go. You said he found a life.
Yeah. Give me Proverbs 3 and 18. Yeah, give me that, too, but give me Proverbs 3 and 18. And then one of you want it. You said it, too.
She is a tree of life to them. Mm-hmm. That lay hold upon
them. Now maybe we might have to go up one verse. I got a few minutes. Give me one. Go up one verse.
Okay. Maybe I'll go up two.
Go up two.
She is more precious than rubies.
Mm-hmm.
No, 13.
Okay.
Happy is the man that findeth wisdom.
Now see, happy is the man that findeth wisdom.
And the man that getteth understanding.
Mm-hmm.
She is more precious than rubies, and all the things that canst thou desire are mm-hmm. not to be compared with her.
That's right.
Now we jump down.
Okay.
She is a tree of life. To
see, this is what we're trying to get you to see. This knowledge of your Creator, mm-hmm. see, of this pattern, of His purpose and His plan. This is the tree of life. Mm-hmm. See, an understanding of Him. Mm-hmm. See, and he who findeth what?
Happy is everyone mm-hmm. that retaineth her. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yahweh by wisdom hath founded the mm-hmm. earth.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. By understanding.
See, happy is her that retaineth her, that retaineth this wisdom. Mm-hmm. See, because we're talking about this tree of life. Now, give me Revelations. Where it talks about, give me the book of life. Actually, I can just do this right here. I don't want to make that hard. Give me Revelations 20, I guess it's 12 through 15. Maybe that's it. See? Because now you look at this. You got a book of life here, and you got a book of life here. See? You have the generations. See, before the generations even come forth, see? But now you have it at the end. See? There's a lot going on between here. In here, there's a lot of people that have died between here and here. See, a lot of people have died in the faith. See, a lot of people that have resurrected with Messiah, and you know, there's also a lot of people that did not. See, go ahead.
Revelation 20:15, mm-hmm. and whosoever is not found written in the book of life mm-hmm. is cast into the lake of fire.
Mm-hmm. Give me one verse up about that.
Okay, let me go 13.
13.
Okay. Okay, and the sea gave up the dead mm-hmm. which were in it, mm-hmm. and death and hell were delivered up,
mm-hmm.
The dead which were in them, and they were judged, every man according to their works,
mm-hmm.
and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire, and mm-hmm. this was the second death.
See, death and hell was cast into the lake of fire.
Okay,
see, all those that have not been all those that have not found in the book of life. See, that means that they're dead. See, go ahead.
Read up the 12th verse.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, and I saw the dead, small and great, mm-hmm. stand before Yahweh.
And the books were open.
And the books were open.
It said, and the books were open. Mm-hmm. See, and we know that we are books. I don't have time to get that. Second Corinthians, I think the third chapter, mm-hmm. said, see, you're an epistle. See, you're a book. Go ahead.
And another book was opened,
mm-hmm.
which was the book of life.
Mm-hmm.
And the dead were judged out of those things that were written in the books.
Mm-hmm. And the books, see, we are books. Mm-hmm. See, but this is the book of life. Mm-hmm. See, go ahead.
According to their works.
Mm-hmm.
And the sea gave up the dead which were in it.
Mm-hmm.
And the dead and death and hell were delivered up.
Mm-hmm.
The dead which were in them, and they were judged every man according to their works.
Mm-hmm.
And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire.
Right, and I said a good example of that is that Red Sea right there.
Mm-hmm.
See how death and hell gave up the dead. Mm-hmm. See, or the Red Sea gave up the Egyptians.
Right. Mm-hmm.
See. And they were dead. Mm-hmm. See. Go ahead.
And whosoever was not found written mm-hmm. in the book of life was mm-hmm. cast into the lake of fire.
That's right. See, so whoever was not found in the book, because remember this, see, that if you are alive, you get to stay in that garden. See,
right.
You get to stay, what garden? You get to stay in that heavenly state. Mm-hmm. See, if you're not, see, you can't be there. Mm-hmm. You understand? You cannot be in that heavenly state mm-hmm. dead. See, right. you have to go. See, and see, what an example of that is, that war in heaven, mm-hmm. see, those angels lost their first estate. They lost it for they cannot what? They could not stay in that garden. And they can't go back because they're what? They're dead. See? And look, it's the same way that angel, see, that was standing there, guarding the
garden.
Exactly. Uh-huh. Guarding that, see, that they could not, because look, dead, you can't go up in there. See? That should mean something to you. You know, like I said, we don't have a lot of time to go into this, but that should mean something to you. See, now, if you look at Revelations, what is in the Revelation? It said that nothing should
defile.
Thank you. Defile should enter therein. Give me that real quick. See, and I believe also, what is it? I don't have time for this. I think it's Ezekiel 47:12. But give me that thing about nothing dead should enter. Not nothing dead. Give me that. I'm thinking about a whole bunch of things. But they let the dead bury the dead.
Mm-hmm.
Mine is gone. Give me give me that in Revelations.
Let me
start with 18.
Okay.
17. And the spirit and the bride say, come, let him that heareth say, come. Mm-hmm. And let him that athirst come. This is mm-hmm. Revelation 22 and 17.
Mm-hmm.
And whosoever will, let him take of the water of life freely.
Mm-hmm. See, that's that water of life freely. Mm-hmm. See, that's that living water. Mm-hmm. See, go ahead.
And for I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this book,
mm-hmm.
if any man shall add unto these things, mm-hmm. Yahweh shall add unto him the plagues that are
that's
written
right.
in this
that's
book.
That's right.
And mm-hmm. if any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy,
mm-hmm.
Yahweh Elohim shall take away his part out mm-hmm. of the book of life.
Now listen, if you're going to say that he was not the one, mm-hmm. see, then you took it away. If you're saying that he wasn't the one, if he wasn't the one, and look, that's worshiping the glory of anything else.
Right.
See, if you change it in any way whatsoever, see the whole Bible testifies to Yahshua's side from start to finish.
Mm-hmm.
See, and if you tamper with any part of it, add your, you or I, if we add our concept, theory, or opinion, then we have tampered with it.
That's right.
See, and that will not go unpunished. Mm-hmm. See, go ahead.
If any man shall take away from the words of the book of the prophecy, Yahweh mm-hmm. shall take away his part out of the book of life
mm-hmm.
and out of the holy city and from the things that are written in this book.
See, we talked about how those angels lost their first estate.
Mm-hmm.
See, we talked about how Adam, see, how he lost his estate up there. See, but Yahweh being that tree of life, see, and mankind or the souls of men, see, him coming to resurrect the souls of men. Now we get to partake. Mm-hmm. Here's the thing, we get to partake of yeah. him. See, now we can partake of him and we can live, what? Forever. See, before, and this, see, now listen now.
Yeah.
This physical body is not going to live forever.
Right.
See, this is a mortal body. Mm-hmm. Just as sure as Adam could not have lived forever in that garden
that's
in
right.
a physical body.
That's right.
See, it is the soul
right.
that's got to live if right. it has right. been resurrected.
Right.
See, what do you got, Patrick? You got your hand up.
22:14.
Okay. Okay.
Blessed are they that do his commandments,
mm-hmm. yeah,
and
right.
they have the right,
right
to the tree of life,
mm-hmm.
and may enter in right. through the gates into the
that's
city.
That's what we're saying. See, that, right. may, that you may enter into the gate right. that have the right. See, you don't have a right, see, to eat of the tree of life, not unless he gives you that right.
Mm-hmm.
See, now, see, that's the right. See, the divine right. See, that's the, see, but look, let's look at this tabernacle real quick. See, look, this high priest, he goes from the court roundabout to the most holy place, see, once a year, see, on the Day of Atonement.
Mm-hmm.
See, and by doing this, see, this is a type and a shadow. If you are made right. one with him, then you are what? You are alive.
Right.
See?
Yeah.
Now look, that made one, a Day of Atonement made one, then made one. See, now look, Adam, see, when Adam was created, see, from the dust of the earth, see, Eve, see, I'm just saying what's in the Bible. Eve was what? In him.
Right.
See? And
right.
she was what? That's a lot. That's been a lot.
Right.
See? Mm-hmm. That's before the transgression.
Right.
See? So if we're clothed in the Messiah,
right.
see, we are what? We are alive.
Right.
What? Forevermore.
Right.
See? Believe right. thou this?
Mm-hmm.
See? We should what? Never die.
Right.
See? Now, Solomon's temple, they took the vessels. We don't have time to get this. They took the vessels of the tabernacle, the golden vessels of this tabernacle, see, typifying your soul, see, from the most holy place and the holy place, and placed that in what? In Solomon's temple.
Uh-huh.
See, showing forth that, see, look, this structure, see, it's a temporary structure. I mean, I know that both of these things tore down. See? Uh-huh. But this was a temporary structure. I'm talking about this physical tabernacle. See? And this temple represents a more lasting structure.
Right.
See, a more lasting structure. Why is that? See, and it was more glorified than what? Than the tabernacle.
Right.
See, why is it more glorified than the why is the temple more glorified in gold and splendor than the tabernacle? See, because it typifies, see, that look, we are placed in him. See, and not only are we alive, see, this is our glory. See, because right. we are glorified in him.
That's right.
See, now, 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter.
Right.
You can in a minute ring the bell. What did I want in 1 Corinthians 15 chapter? The life, the death and hell is...
Life and death swallowed up in victory.
Yeah, that's right. What I want. Right. See, that's what I want. See, I need somebody to get that quick, though. Okay.
Okay.
15. I don't know where. I know it's not doing a good job of this, but... hurry up, because I'm going to move real quick in a couple minutes, and if I can. Read that, Patrick.
Okay, fine.
I'm telling you to read it. I'm not telling you where to read, but read it.
For
Death and death and hell is swallowed up.
Maybe it's 51, 52, 53, 54, something like that.
Okay, let me do 51.
Thank you.
Behold, I will show you a mystery. Mm-hmm. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed.
Mm-hmm.
In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump.
Mm-hmm.
For the trump shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible.
That's what we want, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. Go ahead.
And we shall be changed.
You can't live forever. You got some people lived a long time, but you can't live forever in this physical body. Mm-hmm. See, you know, I remember when I was 22. See, mm-hmm. But that don't mean nothing. I remember it, but it don't mean nothing. I remember Myra when she was 18. Mm-hmm. It don't mean nothing. Because we all do what? We age. Mm-hmm. See, we get old. This body decays. Yeah. But see, we're talking about your soul. But see,
right.
Your soul, no, it doesn't decay.
Right.
See, this is what lives forever. It's your soul if you have the Holy Spirit. It's the glorification. See, it's the body to reflect that. See, and that is done in Yahshua the Messiah.
Right.
See, go ahead.
For this corruptible must put on incorruption, mm-hmm. and this mortal must put on immortality.
Mm-hmm.
So when this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality,
mm-hmm.
then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written,
mm-hmm.
Death is swallowed up in victory.
Death is swallowed up into victory.
Oh, death, where is thy sting?
Mm-hmm. See, we ain't got to worry about nobody dying no more.
Yeah.
See, death. No more death.
Right.
See, and listen, mm-hmm. I know that if you are alive, you're alive forevermore.
That's
in your
right.
heart and your mind. But
right.
we're talking about, you ain't got to worry about going to the physical, just body, nothing.
Right.
See, no more of that. Death is swallowed up in victory.
Right.
See, go ahead.
Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory?
Good,
oh,
death.
The sting of death is sin.
All right, that's good. Go ahead.
Okay.
Hurry up.
Isaiah 25:8.
Mm-hmm.
He will swallow up death and victory.
See, the same thing.
And
right, go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Yahweh Elohim will wipe away
all tears
from all faces.
That's right.
And the
see, you ain't got to worry about that no more. See, when
right.
the Messiah said, let the dead, when the disciple said, hey man, I got to go bury my father. No, let the dead bury the dead. Now, how's the dead going to bury the dead?
Yeah.
See, that don't even make good sense. How's the dead going to bury the dead? See, but he's talking about dead. See, awake thou, like it says 5:14. I don't know. Yeah, this is sleepers, exactly. Now, let me do this real quick. Look, you see right here, in this ark, everybody that was in this ark from a physical standpoint, they were alive. Everything that was not in this ark was
dead.
What? Was dead.
Yeah.
See, this is typified being in Yahshua the Messiah.
Right.
See, everybody that was on the other side, now listen to this, everybody that was on the other side of this cloud, see, was alive.
Mm-hmm.
See, was headed for what? For life.
Mm-hmm.
See, they went through the, on the dark side,
yeah.
headed for what? Death.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, light,
right.
dark.
Yeah.
See,
right.
Because
right.
they gave them
right.
light, but it was darkness to the Egyptians.
Mm-hmm.
You
right.
see that? See,
right.
if you're in that darkness, doesn't darkness typify what? Death.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
so darkness typified death. When Yahshua went into the graves, see, he preached to the graves. See, and like I said in Isaiah the 61st chapter, he went to the prison and preached. See, when he went in there, those that resurrected with him being the first fruit, and then they resurrected after his resurrection. See, he had to be the first, see, to resurrect, and then after his resurrection. See, just like this high priest, see, he had to go, see, first, see, to make the atonement, and then the children of Israel were saying, what? Forgiven.
Right.
You see that?
Right.
See, Yahshua Messiah is the first. See, he has to come forth what? Elohim has to come forth first out, and
right.
then life comes what? Out
right.
of him.
Right.
See, you see that?
Right.
See, so that's
right.
see, look, you got to take off this flesh here first.
Yeah.
See, and then you see what? The more glorified
right.
structure.
Yeah.
See, you
yeah.
see the more immortal life. See,
yeah.
the life
yeah.
without death. See,
right.
but you got to get past what? The sixth step. See,
right.
to go into what? The seventh step.
Yeah.
It's like this high priest had to go what?
Right.
From the sixth step.
Right.
Sin had to be what? The flesh had to be ripped. And the sin had been forgiven. And then it goes to the seventh step. See?
Right.
You see that?
Right.
See?
Right.
Trying to get you to see. That's what we're looking at. See? Life. Everlasting life. See?
Right.
And that's what it typifies. See, that's why there has to be some life. See, in this holy place. See, because what? All of them that died here, but see, it's the newborn that goes what? Over on the other side. See,
right.
It's the life, the
yeah.
newborn, that typifying your soul to go what? Over to the other side. See,
right.
you can't go to the other side unless you what? Born again. See,
right.
if you're born again, that's life.
Yeah.
See, that's
yeah.
life being what? Born again over to the
right.
other side. See,
right.
and without that, you can't go. Say, how can I enter into my mother's womb? See,
right.
unless you what? See, you don't understand. See, you got to be what? Born again.
Right.
Born from what? From above. See,
right.
see, and your
right.
name has to be written what? In that
book
of life.
Yeah.
Right. See, if it's written in that book of life, no, see, as Doc said in one of the tapes, see, look, if he, all right, I got 1 second. Yeah, as Doc said in one of the tapes, look, folks, he talked about the Pope of Rome, see, mm-hmm. casting people out of the church. He said, look, he ought to cast you out of the church. It's his church. But you don't want to miss him being a blotting you out, see, out of the book of life.
Right.
See,
right.
You don't want to be blotted out of that book of life. See, right. I didn't get a chance to get it, but Ezekiel, the 47th chapter, talk about the leaves for the trees for the healing of the nations.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
And see, that's trees for the healing of the nations. In Revelation, talk about the trees. See, for what? For the healing of the 12, for the healing of the nations, talk about in Revelation, but, you know, I don't have time to get it. But, folks, look, this is what this is really all about. Coming to class, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. I got 2 seconds. I can increase it by 2 seconds. Doomsday clock. Look, if we understood the importance of this teaching, and the only way you're going to understand is Josh would make you understand, and I'm going to say this, we would run the class, you know, because running the class, you would be here. This is important.
Yeah.
It is your soul that is at stake. All right? See, I know that we can get things fast now.
Yeah.
You know, how fast can we get it? You get it on the internet. Mm-hmm. See, you can get things fast.
Mm-hmm.
See,
mm-hmm.
but supping with the brethren,
yeah.
coming down here,
right.
see, it's encouragement.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
and we need that encouragement.
Yeah.
See, because yeah. we all represent that tree, see? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
and we eat from each other.
Yeah.
See, we eat from mm-hmm. each other. See, mm-hmm. and to see the presence of the brethren.
Right.
See, that's what we want to see.
Right.
See? Mm-hmm. See that there's life.
Yeah.
See, that's what we represent, life. We represent this bride down here.
Yeah.
See, and this bride is not, listen, this bride is not sitting at home. Mm-hmm. See, this bride is at that mountain.
Yeah.
Hearing those words.
Right. Yeah. Right.
You know, and I know sometimes you can't come to class. I'm not talking about that. I'm just talking about when you can come.
Yeah.
See, ask him to make you study.
Mm-hmm.
Ask him to make you come to class. Mm-hmm. That's what I have to ask.
Mm-hmm.
With that, all glory go to him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That concludes class for today. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise Elohim, our Savior, through Yahshua the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory and majesty, dominion and power, both before all times, now and ever. Let us all say hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.